Similarly, in Tachashila, they were teaching practical life, how to archery was taught, how to fight with animals was taught, how to tame an elephant was taught. Apart from that, they had so many different aspects of maths and science. We were pioneers in science. Delhi Science Pillar, even today, has not rusted after 1600 years. Because those days itself, our people, some of our people, had known how to segregate iron ore separately, removing the oxide in that, because of which it did not rust, and even today it has not rusted. We had Aryabhatta, great astronomers, who could accurately calculate the time the earth takes to revolve around the sun without any equipments. And we had great surgeons, Shushruta, Sharuha, who could conduct various surgeries. But what happened later on? The deterioration came in because of the division of the caste system. The education which was universal under the Gurukul at one point of time was divided based on the caste. The upper caste, lower caste, that division deprived certain section of the society from education. And that led to the deterioration in science. Today we cannot call ourselves as world leaders in certain areas. Yes, even today we are world leaders in space science, we are world leaders in certain aspects of software technology, but the basics, some of that we have lost. So these losses have to be rectified. The next generation has to once again understand the necessity of unity and diversity. Buddhism was born in this country. Jainism was born in this country. Sikhism was born in this country. And Hinduism was born in this country. All these religions have contributed for the global oneness. All the religions have taught about only universal brotherhood. But now, in the name of religion, there is division. Culture. We have had various cultures. Even today, from within a state itself, different districts, you have different diversities. Mr. Devasahayam has written on diversities. The food habits, the various foods available within Tamil Nadu. How it is spread over in different districts, in different styles. Even now, if you go to the tribal area, the tribes, they live in a society where they contribute for the health for the others. You go to Nagaland or Mizoram or Tripura, people, if they want to construct a house for somebody, the entire village, each house, somebody will join a group. They will go to the jungle, cut down bamboos, come and break it. Within few days, they construct a house and hand it over to their person. No cost involved, no expenditure involved, except sharing their food. That's a wonderful culture which still exists. And languages, we have, I think, 711 languages in this country. But in spite of that, we stand as one. We stand as India. We stand as united people in unity and diversity. That is why we have thought about this subject, this topic, so that we can plan for our future through your education of the children. In the classrooms, tell the people, tell the children what is the important for the unity and diversity. My dear teachers, today the world is changing, technology is changing, artificial intelligence is trying to take over, and today we are proud that these schools, the SBOS schools, have been taking everything forward with a vision. That is why today the CBSE school is ranked as number one CBSE school in the entire country by education today. And we have been getting various awards and accolades, not only for the institution but also for the individuals. And today, our Atal Tinkering Labs, which you should make use of fully, the technology advancement which is taking place, we have got Atal Tinkering Lab. Initially we got it for junior college, now we have got it for another four schools. That should be used as a platform to develop innovative skills of our children. Teaching today is no more imparting knowledge. It is just to support the creativity in the child, to bring out the talents of the child and improve their skills in various fields. So for which you will have to do a lot of work, and I am very happy that when I appealed last year that why we keep on still singing Baba Black Sheep and Rain Rain Go Away, let us prepare our own rhymes. And you have done that great hard work. And we will be releasing that CD containing 100 rhymes which is created by our own teachers. It's a great pride for the institution that our teachers have been able to create that. And that will spread to the entire country, maybe even abroad. I salute each one of the teachers who have been involved in that process. My dear teachers, when I appreciate the teachers, I always say that we are the best. SBOA teachers are the best. But when teachers, some of them, they do not adhere to certain principles, we are also very strict. I have been telling that taking tuition is banned in this institution. In spite of that, some teachers continued to. So I had to give a letter, ask for explanation, and those who apologized, saying that yes, it's our mistake, we will not repeat it, we have given a warning letter. But one teacher defended, saying that no, I am not taking tuition, I am not taking money. I transferred him. He came back with his wife and pleaded that I have put in this many years of service. I am known as one of the best teachers. I said, yes, that's why people come to you for tuition. But you should tell them that you will not take tuition. And you have defended yourself, saying that you have not been taking tuition, but you are taking only free coaching for the children. So there is no way. And he said that, I want to resign. He said, gladly resign. Accepted his resignation and sent him. So, this institution which is taking care of you well, will continue to take care of you well. I have already started working, our treasurer is working with the internal auditor, how to implement the next salary revision. Very soon you will be getting your salary raise based on the pay commission which has been given. But in the meantime, you should continue to develop yourselves. You have to develop your skills. I had a teacher's parents interaction recently, and some of the feedback they gave, it is something which you have to correct. So I'll just list out what it is and I will conclude. One, they say that some of our teachers, they are harsh while handling the children. Some teachers are writing on the blackboard what is their homework for class 2 children, class 1 children, who will not be able to copy it properly. The vehicle traffic is not properly monitored. Some teachers alone are given permission to come to the classroom and take children back. There is a partiality shown was the complaint. Equal opportunity is not given to all the children. Washrooms are not clean. The teachers themselves are not teaching, talking good English. glad that Dr. Indira Jairaj organized a training program for teachers for English speaking, and I was happy to give them a certificate, and I interacted with them. How much they have improved was a great learning. Everyone should be thorough in English. There were also complaints of some teachers not having adequate quality of teaching. In some classes, some money is collected for some functions through the children. That is not correct. You should ask the parents to deposit in an account. Olympiads are announced, but not adequate coaching is done. Projects are being done by the parents and not by the children. And it is involving huge costs. There is occasionally water scarcity. Handbook is not used by some of the teachers. They have also demanded that during the beginning of the academic year, please have a meeting in which you introduce the teacher to the parents, so that we will know to whom we can communicate regularly. Basic communication is lacking, and general knowledge is not adequate was one suggestion. And in one of the books, they were saying that there is a book on knowing your personality, where Sinistra's photos are put. Please have a look at it. Those kind of books we should discard and go for alternate books. Grammar book is needed more, they were saying. And some teachers are not dealing with the parents well. Some children are even today given harsh punishment, which is not allowed in the institution. And they have also demanded that let there be a separate change room for the girl students. Wherever possible, we'll have to make arrangement. And they were also requesting that hold PTA meetings regularly, share the syllabus with the parents so that they know what is to be taught at home, and some of them can do it well. And one complaint was that when the children are asked to have their food, that time in the smart board, some video keeps on playing. So they are not concentrating on the food, but concentrating on the video. And in one occasion, they said that for a class one child, the result was withheld. How can you withhold the result of a class one child? And they also requested that give us a parent ID and to come inside the school, provide a biometric access so that only the parents can come. That at the trust level, we will think and take it forward. And they were also requesting for a weekly email to be sent on what activities are being done in the school, so that the parents come to know the whole thing and they can also support. My dear teachers, the teachers are the innovators. You are the creators. You have so much of creativity in you. I have seen you have put up stalls. In every program when we announce, I know how much of involvement is there from the correspondents, principals and the teachers, that you bring in so many new ideas. You have that talent. Only thing my appeal to you is that spare some extra time to bring in that creativity. I know you are overburdened, you have double burden, you have to look after your family, children. In spite of that, you can make the difference. I still remember the book which we gave to you, Be the Change, 2 years back, has that story of a teacher. When teaching was criticized in a meeting held by a businessman, the teacher stood up and said that, what way I make it different? I as a teacher can make my child which will not speak to speak. I can make a child which will sit in the classroom for 45 minutes without creating any problem in the class. Silence. And I am a teacher who can identify the weakness of the children and make them better citizens by providing support. I am a teacher who can bring in confidence in my children. And I am a teacher who can bring out the creativity of the child. And what I do is I make a difference. That is all what you are making, and I am sure that you will continue to make that difference. And in this trust, it will always endeavor to give you the best. And I would also like to introduce you to you from a difference in the past. We have decided who will succeed me as the secretary and correspondent. I introduce Comrade Selvaraj. He will be taking over from me on 1st July 2018 as the secretary and correspondent of this school. So, my dear teachers, this school, this institution, SBOE, all the 12 schools are making a difference, and you will continue to make a difference with your hard work, involvement and creativity. Thank you. Thank you, Ananda.
We congratulate our secretary and correspondent in advance for having been nominated for the Award of Brand Leaders 2017-18. Thank you, sir, for your thought-provoking deliberations and for highlighting the areas that require improvement. It's my privilege to introduce Ms. Madhushalini IAS, currently Indian strategist at Khan Academy, where she leads work with schools and with strategic partners. Prior to this, she was a member of the Indian Administrative Service of the 2008 batch and served in Uttar Pradesh cadre. During her training at the LBS National Academy of Administration, Missouri, she was the recipient of the Director's Gold Medal in Law and Economics. A topper throughout her academic journey, she also enjoys reading, crafting, cooking, and forever learning to do something new. We are proud to say that she is an alumna of SBOA School and Junior College. Though Ms. Madhushalini IAS could not be with us in person, we shall now listen to her keynote address via Skype.